Welcome back, everybody in Internet Land. We're gonna start playing more Sonic 2006 today, and we're gonna be playing as Silver the Hedgehog now. It's a brand new character, and he's got brand new things to give to the series. So, those brand new things include some really terrible looking buildings. This isn't a good looking place. It's full of fire and horrible. Just look at it. It's like Fallout, kind of. I don't know. So, look, there's a whole bunch of fire. Let's get that out of our way. We don't need fire floating around here. They burn away at my world, destroying everything in their path. So Silver's pretty cool. He's floating around. He's got all this crazy blue stuff around him. He's the flames of disaster known as Iblis. He's pretty crazy. So we're bound to be able to do something cool with the crazy flying guy, right? Oh, and he's got a friend, too. It's Blaze the Cat. I'll go into her later. She's a cool character. So, we'll get to that. But this isn't Blaze the Cat's story. It's Silver the Hedgehog. So, gonna start off by talking about Silver instead. This first level is Crisis City, as you can see from this very generous loading screen. It's going to take plenty of time to let us know what that level is. And Silver is, he's shoving boxes around. Look at that, you press some buttons and it's box shoving time, so. So we'll see how he shoves those boxes. I don't know, you saw Sonic's video, maybe, so. So basically what happens here, oh, he's going to explain it for me. Thank you, mysterious voice, for taking what I was gonna say and doing it instead. So yeah, Silver can pick things up with his mind. He's telekinetic, he's got psycho powers, and you can pick things up with the right trigger. You can throw them by hitting the attack button, and yeah, you could also float for a short time, which is also very handy. You got these circles on the ground, so you hit the right trigger, and it'll use that circle, fling you into the air. You use these, you could hit the, you could, not only can you use all the items you pick up to attack enemies and whatnot, but you could use them to affect the surroundings around you, so. Lots of physics going on, lots of crazy nonsense. You hit the freeway portion there, it's gonna knock it down, we can continue on, so. Watch out for these guys. Also that right there, when you're floating around, if you just tap the button instead of holding it, it's kind of an oversight. You'll get a little bit farther with using less of your meter in the bottom corner, so. Whoa, crap, that was close. Anyway, yeah, the meter's very important to Silver, completely unlike Sonic. When you pick things up, it takes a little bit of your meter away, and you won't get that back until you throw all of the items you have on you, so. The more items you have, the less of the meter you're going to be able to use. The floating also takes away from the meter, so if you're holding things while you need to float, you're not going to get the full meter out of it. So you probably want to throw everything away before you start floating around. So we'll get on over this way. There's another item box over here. There we go. Let's take them out first. Okay, so. So one up, perfect. We're probably gonna need a whole ton of those, knowing how this game works. Yeah, Silver is very much different than Sonic and Shadow in regards to, you know, speed first of all. He's not a fast character, but it's okay because it feels like it gives the game a lot less opportunity to glitch out on everybody, you know? The game is very buggy, very unprogrammed, but it almost feels like they wanted to do Silver's game first. Like, they got the Havoc's physics engine for this. It's pretty crazy physics stuff going on. Everything bouncing around everywhere. Silver throwing bitches left and right, so. You know, while he's doing that, it's kind of a slow-paced game. You've got, you know, full control over all these objects around you, and it's pretty impressive, you know? And meanwhile, Sonic and Shadow, they both have fast-paced gameplay, and a lot of things break around that, you know? You go fast enough, you're gonna get into areas you don't belong in, you're gonna get all these power-ups that don't work, and things just tend to go wrong in their stories, but Sonic and Shadow, pretty messed up. Silver, not too bad. There's actually times in the story that I enjoy playing as him. I know it's crazy to say about this game. sure you remember, like, you're playing Sonic 2006 here, you're not allowed to enjoy anything. Well, you know what? You're wrong. Even the worst games have a... Oh my god, I can't believe I'm about to make this pun. Even the worst games have a silver lining. Oh, god, that hurt. I'm sorry. I was setting that up, and I didn't notice it until I was right about to say it. And I don't regret it. Silver's a fun character. Most of the time. He's pretty crazy looking, too. He looks like he's from the future. He's got, like, all these glowing arms, or these glowing, like, gloves and boots and everything. And he's got this crazy hairstyle, because, you know, the future's gonna be. Everyone's gonna have, like, mohawks and purple hair and all sorts of crazy shit, you know. No one has normal hair in the future. If the media has taught me anything, it's that. So Silver fits right in, and he looks different from people in the present day, so he did a good job in relaying that. And be really careful around here, because all the objects are kind of tilted all weird, so platform jumping is a little bit difficult. You get the silver medal to the right, and we'll just float, get that real quick, because it's right there, why not, right? We might as well get it if it's right there, even if we're not going to do anything with it. So we'll float past these suckers, hit this, and it'll fling us into the second part of the level. So I'll see what's going to go on here. We're going to fling more boxes at people. It's going to be a great time. And yeah, as you can see, like, it starts off in the future. It's not exactly a great place, and Silver very understandably wants to take care of that. But Silver's not the only one who wants to make things better. We're gonna be playing as Blaze the Cat right here. And Blaze is an awesome character. She's a whole lot of fun. She's got the speed like Sonic does, but she's got control over fire, so she can do, like, fire attacks. She can double jump right here, make a little fire tornado. That's kinda cool. She's got a few attacks in her arsenal. She can home, kind of a homing attack. It's not just like Sonic's, but if you jump in the air and then hit the attack button, you're gonna home in on enemies if you're close enough to them. If you aren't close enough to them, you're just gonna kind of fly around like crazy, but that's also okay, so. Like that, see? It's pretty wild. If you're close enough, you'll hit them. It's pretty nice. She's got a couple other attacks that I can't remember how to do, but it's okay too. There he is. Alright, I should go down and hit that. And, yeah, Blaze is, she's from Sonic Rush originally. It was a game for the, it was the first game for the Nintendo DS. And, so you can do this too. I don't know how I did this. It's pretty distracting. She'll take him out, she'll take everyone else around him. But yeah, Sonic Rush was the first Sonic game for the Nintendo DS. You get to play as Sonic, and you get to play as Blaze, and they were both pretty much the same character with... I can't remember if their levels are exactly the same or just similar, but they are both pretty fun. And Blaze is an interesting character. She's just not a really terrible character like other cats in this series. She's not a really obnoxious character like other female characters in the series. And, you know, she's just a fun, interesting character, I guess. She's cool looking. Take care of herself. She doesn't have to, like, rely on Sonic or whine about things or be super confident. She's just, I don't know. But it doesn't matter anymore because we're going on to the next section. That most likely means we're not going to be playing as a Blaze anymore because they got to take away all the cool stuff from us and give us back Silver, who's still alright. You know, it's not a big deal. We're going to be playing as Silver for most of this, so we might as well adjust to him. I think we're doing a good job so far. Just get right back on over to Silver. There we go, okay. And there he is. Perfect, so. Start this up again. Getting hit by cars, look at this. We're just standing there oblivious to what's behind him. Cars keep rolling down. Oh, God, where did that come from? That didn't hurt me. That would have been awful. So fly up here. I don't know how to get that coin. The coin's really high in the air. Oh, it doesn't matter. We're not after him. Oh, crap. Ow. So, another kind of good thing to notice about... Hey, another one up. Another good thing to notice about Silver's gameplay is there's a lot of enemies that will throw, like, physical objects at you. And those are really important because you're not always going to have parts of the environment to manipulate and throw at people. You've got these guys will shoot fireballs at you, like I just got hit with. So you know that they're being mutinous, but... You've got, you know, different enemies will throw different things. The guy's got a huge rock. That giant rock. That also hurts. Just demonstrated that. But if you don't have any objects or anything, you can pick those up. You know, rockets, fireballs, whatever happens to be being shot at you. Also, if you stand on top of an object, use your telekinetic powers like that. You can use it like a platform for a short time, so that helps you get around to areas that you can't usually get to. That's good stuff. But yeah, you gotta, you know, do whatever you can to kill the enemies around you, and you don't get too many options right off the bat, but if you get some power-ups later on, it'll definitely help Silver out, so keep that in mind. We'll keep on going for now. Get this one-up. One-ups are great. We need all the one-ups we can get, because I don't trust this game. So, you know, oh, jeez, where did that pole go? It's flying. Right, watch out for that one. The tornado's gonna start chucking things at us, so we gotta get behind this wall. We're gonna be safe right back here. Or maybe we won't be, I don't know, so. We gotta destroy this wall over here. We need to pick up something. We gotta throw it right over at the wall. That guy behind it is helping out too. He's chucking fireballs and he's blowing up that wall. Perfect, thank you. I'll spare your life for helping me through that wall. Get to that goal ring. We're done here. No more Crisis City. Let's chalk that score up. That's definitely enough for an S rank. Alright, Silver's gonna sit there and float like a super confident boss. But you know what? That's okay. He deserves it. Because we got that S rank. We did a good job. We're gonna get some gold medals out of it. There's one for the level. There's one for the S rank. There it is. Alright. Let's continue on, see what else happens to Silver. Got to that tornado, so let's see what that was all about. So, oops, something's... Oh, God, look at that guy. He's huge. It's absolutely enormous. I wonder what the hell this is all about. It's a crazy lava golem creature.
Come on, you monster!
Well, that doesn't help, though. I can tell he's a monster, Silver. That's pretty obvious. He's got four arms. What kind of normal not monster has four arms? Answer me that. I don't know the answer. So we're going to be fighting this guy. Looks pretty menacing here. It's Iblis. What the... That's not how I remember Iblis looking. He was some weird-looking worm thing. You hated platforms and good boss battles. So hopefully this one goes a little better. Iblis is... I don't know, it's like every time you see Iblis in this game, he takes on a different form, and there's no real reason to it that I know of. Because you got... Like, you saw the other crazy monster of the week that not all the other Sonic games had. You had Chaos, you had the Bio Lizard, you had, you know, things that... Kinda made sense, I guess. I don't want to say that, because they really didn't, but... I don't know. You had to... Like, Chaos changed form because he got the Chaos Emeralds. That made sense. The Bio Lizard didn't change form because he just attached his ass to a space shuttle. I don't know, but this guy just... He changes, and you don't know why. Every time you see him, he looks different. He's gonna drop a building on our heads. That was fantastic. Yeah, point of this boss, you gotta chuck things at his head. If you chuck them anywhere else, you're not gonna do damage, but you gotta pick up debris hanging around here, shoot him in the head, and just knock his armor off. So that's a good start there. We got a shoulder armor missile. Let's see what else we can do. So we're gonna miss most of those, that's whatever. Watch out for his attacks, but a lot of his attacks bring back some things you could throw at him, like those rocks. Some of those rocks will stay around there. If he smashes you with a building, there's building debris on the ground, so... You know, whatever you can work with. Get a chuck another building at us. Let's stay off kind of the side here. I think we'll be okay. That's it. Yeah, going to the left. We won't be fine. It's a big building. It kind of hurt. Let's throw this at you. I think when he covers his face like that, when he crosses his arms, you can't hit him like that, so you gotta wait for it. Knock off the rest of his armor.
It's not over yet. Don't let your guard down, Silver.
Just got a little bit more. Let's just hit him a few more times. I'm sure there's something around here we can throw in his face. What's that? Over here? No? Okay. Oh, God. He starts doing that. He's low on health. He starts breathing fire at you. That's hard to avoid, but... doesn't matter, we got our rings back. It looks pretty weird without any of his armor on. It's a weird looking hunchback thing. Anyway, throw more stuff at him. Hit him in the head, it's important. He's gonna throw another building, that ain't good. And we're 2 for 2 on buildings, it's gonna hurt. Okay, cool, we missed the third one, so. Alright, just gonna hit him like one more time, and there we go, alright. Iblis down. It's great. That went a lot better than the other Iblis fight. I'm proud of that. So, look at me. So dramatic. Just melting in the lava. It's like the ending of Terminator. His hand's gonna go down. He's gonna give us the thumbs up before he... No thumbs up? Alright. That's... we'll work with that. I guess. Anyway. Okay, so we beat that. Silver's gonna float around some more. And he deserves that, because he got another S rank. It's awesome. Just S ranking all over here. Let's get a couple more medals out of that. Always a good thing. You can never have too many of these medals. I don't even know what they do, but they're shiny. They look nice. So we'll hold on to them. Save that data. What's gonna happen after this fight? We beat Iblis. Is that the best of it? Are we gonna fix the future now? Hope so. This is looking pretty terrible here.
Looks like we stopped it for now.
But it'll just rise up from its ashes again.
Well, that's not good. That doesn't seem fair at all.
It'll never end.
Calm down, Silver.
Then tell me what we should do. How can we completely destroy Iblis?
That's a pretty good question. That's... I don't know if I'd want to live in a future like this, honestly. Wait, who said... you were... Shadow?
Just as a flower comes from a seed.
What's Shadow doing here? Why does he sound completely different?
Everything has an origin.
And why is he rambling nonsense? And where'd all his color go?
Responsible for this catastrophe.
Is that really the answer to our problem? Tell me, do you know who it is?
Is that the wrong question to ask? Or are you gonna kill me now? That's pretty creepy. Stop staring, please. You're freaking me out. That was unnerving. I didn't like the looks of that guy.
To fix this present timeline, you need to change the past.
Apparently he's good enough, I mean...
But that's impossible!
Oh, there's a Sega logo on the back of one of those signs there.
You can't.
That's weird. Look at that, you can see it, it's like right above
because
the node.
I have the power to travel through time.
No wow, that's way. Awful convenient.
In order to change the past, you must eliminate the individual who has awakened Iblis. The Iblis Trigger.
We have to give him a special name. That doesn't sound too bad.
If I eliminate that guy, will our world be saved?
Sure, why not? Save that world.
Disaster. Here are my records of this event.
So this guy seems legit enough. He's just trying to help the future out. Not a big deal, right?
Were released into the world.
Looks like Soliana right there.
This person to blame.
Oh, well, this sounds familiar. Remember this? Picking up that Chaos Emerald again. Damn Chaos Emerald ruining ever. Oh, there's someone in. It's Sonic. That.
I see it.
Why would Sonic? That doesn't
that
even.
Blue Hedgehog's the ablest trigger?
Oh, we can't. Sonic doesn't do things like that. Crazy talk.
I'll send us back in time to the point when the Iblis trigger was alive.
Well, that's nice of you. Super convenient time travel. Well, this looks a lot better than the city did. And there's Silver. Where's everybody else? Guess I didn't feel like coming.
Where am I?
That's not nice.
Blaze? Blaze!
Well, Silver's all alone now. That's pretty depressing.
Guess we all got separated.
Guess so.
This is so unbelievable. Now, I must fight for the future.
Hell yeah, future. Let's go fight for that stuff. Let's go find that Iblis trigger. He's Sonic. He's gotta be around somewhere. Sonic's just all over the place. We know that. You can never not find Sonic most of the time. Just gotta wait for this to load first. Maybe then we'll find him. He's gotta be around. Okay, here we go.
Where is he?
Well, let's check the forest first. This place was very clearly not designed for Silver. Like Sonic and Shadow can run across this no problem, but Silver just takes forever. There's so much of it. Let's go check out this way first. There's people over here. And we'll follow them and see what's going on. So I remember this place. We're running down over to the jungle. Let's go see what we can do there. So we can't run across the water, obviously, because Silver on top of being slow doesn't have a princess. We can use this thing, however. It's going to make some platforms in the middle of the lake, so let's float over to those. Alright, great. Wait for that bar to fill back up. That part's important. And this one. Oops, get over here. Alright, great. Let's get into the jungle. So Silver's still chucking boxes. It's like the only thing he's good for. It's a good thing everyone leaves these boxes just inexplicably everywhere. I don't even know what's in these boxes. You got the wooden ones, the metal ones are just everywhere for some reason. I don't know why boxes suddenly became a staple. Like, ever since Sonic Adventure 2, there's just boxes littering the place.
It looks like this Lotus will help me jump based on how long I charge my psychokinesis.
Well, that's convenient. Cool. Okay. That looks like it's in our way, so let's destroy it. Get it out of here. Head over this way. Let's see what's going on in this place. See, he shoots rockets. You can pick those rockets up and throw them away, so it's really good to have, in case there's nothing else around you. We'll hop onto this log. And this log will let us if you... God, rocket. Okay. Forget that. I need a ring. Now, those logs, if you use your psychokinesis on them, you can bring them up one side, and then it'll start swinging around. And I don't know, it seems like it could be useful, but most of the time it's really not, because it's hard to do anything with that log once it starts swinging, and it doesn't swing for very long, so. Don't know why they bothered with it, but it's okay, we'll get past this somehow anyway. It's a very strange level for Silver. First of all, like, the music doesn't feel sound familiar from Sonic's part of it at all. Let's get around on the turtle, then. Hop on that turtle's back. It's gonna take us for a ride. We'll see where we end up.
This hanging ruin might be useful.
Let's take it with us. Why not? Throw to that. I see that was very useful. Yeah, it'd still be hanging there. So that's the log we just passed earlier. Go underneath that. You don't want to hop back up onto it because you're going to end up right where you were. And that guy's a bad shot there. We don't have to deal with him. More ruins. We got this turtle. Let's go over and jump onto the turtle. That seems alright. Well, where are you going to take us? Watch out for this. Turtle's just small enough to go underneath it, but we won't go with them. So, let's see what's over here. We got one of those glowing plant things. Let's swing across it. Spring us up over this way. A little bit more. Perfect. Alright. Guys with the rock, I'll throw those rockets back. It's like some sort of crazy matrix thing going on there, you know? So this right here is where the level just... This level doesn't make any sense whatsoever. I'm just gonna come right out with it now. It's a very, very wide open level. There's a lot of architecture and whatnot to it, and it's very difficult to tell where you're actually supposed to go in this level. Let's see here. Can't break that. That's not working. If we is there something back here that opens it, maybe? Maybe a metal box will work. Nope. Okay. Can we fly around it? Yeah, let's go over this way. Alright, can we just fly around? There's a checkpoint back here and everything. So let's hurry up. Is this where I'm supposed to go? This doesn't seem right. Maybe over this way. What's over here?
Be careful not to fall in.
Right up here? Yeah, let's keep following this. This might be the right way to go. I'll have to look to this place. Okay, so up here. Take out that guy, because he's in our way.
These are submerged ancient ruins.
Good job, Silver. That... You got like halfway through this level and it just now dawns on you that these could be ruins. Alright, so this looks promising. Let's hit this checkpoint here and looks like we continue on over this way, so how do we get to there? I don't think I'd float high enough. Let's see if we could use this, swing us over and no, that's not gonna. You see when you swing this, it's really hard to move, and then oh god, I was lucky. Okay, yeah, because the camera just stays, like, right back there. You can't tell where you are in the log in comparison to anything else, really, because it's a weird camera angle. And, like, the log doesn't fling around long enough for you to get any distance because of this. So this is troubling. What happens when I bring it this way? Is this... No, this doesn't work either. Okay, Whoops. There's just the one up in that cage there. So this looks like it's all there is to this part of the level. You guys, throwing your hands at me. Kinda weird. Anyway, ignore those. He's not gonna do us any good. It's gotta be something to do with this. So we just swing this up, bring it down. There's not enough swing to... No, I can't make that. There's no way I can... No, I can't make it back either. Great. Alright, let's try that again. I swear these logs are just the stupidest... No, that's not certainly not gonna work. Alright, get back on the log. Calm down, Silver. How is that supposed to work? Doesn't make any sense. Okay, can I just reach that? No. Maybe I can't do that from here. Gotta get in closer to the middle. And can you just grab onto the... Thank you. Jeez, Silver. jump? Nope. Jumping just throws you backwards. That's okay, okay. We're almost... We can do this. Are you kidding me? We can't do this. Can't do anything. Very sick of this log here. Gonna do something good for us, right, log? Jump over... No, you just start flying backwards when you're on that. I don't get this. Is there something over here? But the checkpoint drops me off looking the other way. Why would I have to go over... Well, there's a turtle. That's something. Let's jump on the turtle. See what he has to do. A helpless turtle? Going over this way. That's a plus, I guess. Let's jump onto this guy. Help us get where we need to go. Spring up. There's a one up. That's good. We just lost a bunch of those. But now the turtle's gone. Are you kidding me? Okay, I'm gonna make it over to here. Yes! Alright, good. I don't even know if that's how I... That's probably not how I'm supposed to do this at all. I don't even care. What was in that? Just... whatever. Great, that pillar got in the way. Can't even kill this guy now. What the... Whatever, let's get this checkpoint. Let's just continue on with the level. What? I was just up. Silver, you're... Am I supposed to hit the checkpoint from the opposite direction? I was already up. That's down so early. It's not going to bounce us high enough. That way just takes us back to where we went. No, I can't get up from there. This way is just... Yeah, I don't want to do it either. Where am I? I need to go up, so can I reach up? Okay, I can't, just barely. Right, that's good, I guess, so... It's still sitting there. Could we just take it? What are you doing underneath that? Why are you hiding, giant robot? Okay, well, there's this fruit right here. I think that'll swing us over to this platform in front of us. We can hit that spring. The spring will take us up a little farther. Alright, great. I feel like we're finally starting to make sense of this level. Yeah, it just... I have no idea what the correct route in this level is supposed to be. It just doesn't make any sense. A whole bunch of crap going. There's like a ton of paths everywhere, and they all seem to connect in this place that you're not supposed to go to. And it's just bad level. It's bad level design. It's terrible programming. Tropical jungle, you should be ashamed of yourself. Here's the only useful log in this entire level. You swing this back, bounce it forward. It's gonna hit that ball. That ball's gonna go flying off into the background. Sit on there and do nothing of any particular use. So, never mind, that was more useful than the other logs, but not by a whole lot, I guess. These guys have lots of exploding barrels over here, or boxes. Square barrels. Alright, great. Let's bounce up this. And there's the goal ring, finally! Jeez! This level couldn't have ended any sooner. Probably didn't get it real great now. You got a pretty terrible score there, actually. Whatever, can't S-rank them all. Well, I guess you could, but... I'm not going to. You're lucky I'm playing this. So one gold medal, that's enough for me. We'll get out of this tropical mess. Oh, it's Blaze the Cat again. Just off in the middle of this beach.
So,
just...
this is the past.
Hey, maybe to you, you know what? We here in the past like to call it the present.
I hope Silver is okay. He's pretty insecure when he's alone.
They're crazy insecure. He's just all sorts of problems.
Blue Hedgehog.
Feel like that should mean something, but look at that, she's just in the middle of a wave ocean, just sitting around. And, oh, sure enough, Wave Ocean. Look at that, we get to play as Blaze now. I'm excited. Blaze is a fun character. So she's stranded in the middle of the beach. Let's get her back to Soliana so we can regroup and figure out what's going on here.
The Ibis trigger. A blue hedgehog. Can it be true? I need to find Silver fast.
I don't know what you're thinking of, Blaze. Anyway. Alright, so Blaze's Wave Ocean right here is an awful lot like Sonic's was. It's pretty much the same route and everything. Just got some more enemies, some different traps here. Well, those spike balls weren't there before. That's a pretty difficult challenge right there. Wasn't sure if I could jump all those spike balls. It's okay, we did, clearly. It's not a big deal. All these enemies are around, let's just take them all out. Blaze's homing attack is a little different than Sonic's, a little more difficult to control, because you gotta be way closer in. If you don't, you just fly around everywhere, so a little bit awkward, but we'll make it work. And let's see, hey, silver metal, great, let's get that. I gotta go over here, try that. Can't, just wanna break a box, jeez, okay, let's double jump up there. Watch out for that guy. Enormous. It's okay, he's dead now. Blaze makes pretty short work out of the bigger enemies like that. It's nice. So that's not the right way. Go grab that. Oh, this back. We haven't done this with any other characters so far. Let's see what's over this way. Just a million springs, some loops, and okay, this is. This isn't exciting. Oh my god, look at all these! There's just so many! Wow, that was so not worth it. Just run under all these. These spikes aren't very intimidating. You just run right under them. I don't know why you make a wall of spikes and then remove the bottom part. Anyway, yes, another one up. Great. Those are helpful here. More springs, and we're gonna chase by that whale. It's just the same exact level over and over again. You can't. Why does this stupid whale have to hate everybody? Don't understand it. Well, look, he's not destroying the docks, though, at least. That's nice of him. He's not gonna completely ruin our party here. Oop, careful to land on that platform. The Blaze's level is a lot shorter though. You don't have to go through that second part. You don't have to go through any ridiculous mock speed section. Gold ring's just right there. Let's hit it and get on out of here. Let's see what we got. Oh, it's definitely gonna be. Yep.
Can't complain.
I can't either, Blaze. You did an excellent job there. Wow, especially if the S rank was only 30,000. I got enough for a regular S rank, and that was a easy mode S rank. So cool, got a couple gold medals out of those, and probably aren't even real gold. I know at this game where they're probably just those chocolates wrapped in gold foil or something. Oh, there's our buddy Sonic. This is right at the start of the game, I remember this.
I finally found him. The Iblis Trigger.
Well, congratulations, Silver. Let's take him out. Let's start killing Sonics.
Oh, I got you, Sonic.
Like, wait, what? What are you?
It's about time, Amy. I finally caught you again.
Are you kidding me? He's not even blue.
Please,
I.
You're not Sonic.
No kidding.
I'm sorry.
Oh, I'm sure you are. You stupid girl.
Huh? Hey, where'd he go?
Amy,
he must have run.
You love Sonic so much, you think you'd recognize him apart from other hedgehogs.
Did you miss someone because of me?
Like, Shadow kinda made sense. At least they're okay. Similar looking, but
sure the guy I'm looking for
Silver is a completely different color. His spines are all weird looking,
what?
And
two heads are better than one when looking for
someone. I don't
hey,
want your help. Trust me. Please.
What's your name?
Silver.
That's a nice name.
Awkward.
It's nice to meet you.
It's like he's ashamed of his own name. And Amy just said that out of courtesy. She's really thinking, like, that's a nice name. Who names someone after the color they are, anyway? That's stupid, and that's borderline racism. Seems like a crazy idea. I don't know why you'd do it. But I don't know. It's not Silver's fault that he's got a stupid name. His parents are just very mean people. I suppose living in the end of the world, you know, you don't have a whole lot of creativity.
Maybe I'll talk to some people in the town.
Yeah, I'll just talk to people. Why not? People are cool. And Sonic's heading in the desert. It's good to know. So maybe we can meet up with him there. We can't get into the desert. Of course not. It's never that easy. They're gonna just let us stroll on in anywhere.
Did Sonic really head to the desert?
Yeah, I think he did.
Do me a favor and help me find him first.
So we gotta find Sonic because that's what Amy wants. And whatever Amy wants, Amy gets because she's crazy and manipulative and we gotta track this Sonic guy down before doing what we're here for. Screw the future. Amy needs help now. Okay, so do we go over? Oh, let's talk to this guy. It's the crazy Mayor Regis guy. Maybe he's got something for us. We got a protected gate. Sounds super exciting. I'm thrilled. You guys ready for this? Hot gate protecting action. You know, if it ever loads, we're gonna eventually protect a gate. Okay, let's get to protecting. There's a bunch of enemies here, of course. It's wouldn't be a mini game in Sonic 2006. But without a ton of enemies to blow up, their idea of doing anything is beating enemies. Just imagine if this is how the game is like, oh, we've got to protect the gate in order for you to get it. Just throw 30 robots at you. Once you beat them, you're good to go. And it's like, I guess that makes sense. If you're protecting something, you gotta protect them from, you know, protect the gate from something. It might as well be robots. But just imagine, like, everything in this game ended up being this. Sonic Story is a perfect example. You gotta unlock some door to a base? Well, the only way to do that is by defeating all the robots. You wanna make a bank withdrawal? Well, you know, these robots are in the way of your money. Very irritating. Very repetitive. I couldn't be bothered to program real minigames in here. It would have been really cool, some sort of like gate defense. Where the gate is a certain amount of HP and you gotta like set up traps or whatever to. No, that'd be way too much time. That didn't seem very Sonic-ish. I don't know. I just wish it was something different, but it's not. It's always the same. It's fight enemies, loading screen, talk to a guy, loading screen, run around town, loading screen. Get an A rank.
Looks like I'm on a roll.
Celebrate. Loading screen. Get a medal, loading screen. Loading screen, loading screen. Alright, I guess this means we can get to the desert now. Enough of that bullshit. And alright, great, we're back. Alright, so let's get back to that desert place. Oh, Amy's gotta follow us forever, and I hope this is short-lived. We find Sonic immediately, and Amy's like, oh, there's my lover, I'm gonna go harass him now, and Silver's like, well, that was cute, but now I gotta kill him, and we do, and everything's okay. Into the desert. ended. More loading screens. Okay.
I sense Sonic's presence here. Call it my girlish intuition.
I don't want to call it anything, Amy. I want to call it creepy. What are you doing, Silver? Just throw her into a cactus and be done with it.
As soon as I find Sonic, I'll help you find who you're looking for, Silver.
Amy, why do you have to come first? I was doing something. You ruined it for me. And we should be hunting for who I'm looking for first.
What?
It's just...
You mean this
it's
desert?
Courteous, Amy.
Everything is so great here, isn't it? The sky is gorgeous and everyone's happy.
Except anyone near you.
Huh?
Yeah, you wouldn't know about happiness.
Let's go. I'll help you find who you're looking for.
Silver, what are you doing? You're on the right track before, but... Anyway, into Dusty Desert, let's find that crazy blue hedgehog. Hopefully he's here somewhere. Protecting princesses, or whatever the hell he does lately. I gotta load him first. You can't find him without making him somewhere.
Just
right.
Wait, Iblis Trigger.
So, Dusty Desert, we're on the inside of it now. It's not like Sonic's level. It's a whole kind of ancient ruins thing going on here, so... Take out these guys, wait for them to throw the bombs at you, and then get blown up by them, because that's exactly how you defeat enemies. Well, there's some jars here, too. Let's just use the jars. That was better. Okay. Now we're out of them, so... Bombs. Pick up the bombs. Pick them up, Silver. There you go. Throw them back. Just one more. And... Alright, here we go. Great. I want more enemies. Let's... Get that ring. Get all those missiles. Throw them back. I'm gonna have missiles to take out everybody. Great. Alright, so the door's gonna... What the hell? Like, there's balls everywhere. Why are all these balls? It's like a pool game, actually. Each corner of the room here has some sort of hole in it, so you gotta make sure all these balls fall in the hole. They slowly count down, and whenever you hit any of them, they count down a little bit more. So what you gotta do is maneuver all these balls into holes before they count down to zero, because then they'll explode and you'll have to do it all over. This isn't going too well. There's only two left. Too much opportunity. Oh, what? There's... I don't know if I could do this. Everything, get in there. Get in there. Get that one in. We should... Oh, they got caught on each other. So if I do this, these are going to explode, and I'm going to have to do it all over again. Here we go. Oh, I only have to do it with the two. That's not bad. That's not bad at all. We could deal with two balls. There's a joke there, I'm not saying it, I'm better than that, so get in there. I'm just gonna get in there eventually. Get this, come on, just get in there, that one's in. Great, okay, so you can go faster. And there we go, so now this door gets to open up. So I'm wasting our time here. This guy out. I need something to work with. Oh, cool, he gets the sands back. Let's grab those. Quit hitting yourself, robot. That's so third grade of you. Alright, so this room's got these giant sand waves right here. You gotta watch out for them because they'll push you all the way back to the start of this room. We gotta make our way over to. We grab this, it gives us more energy. We could use that to miss that platform. And, oh crap, spike balls. The spike balls hurt too. You gotta get rings back. It's gonna push. Whoa, crap. Gotta push a spike ball. Oh my god, did it really? Just get out of here, spike ball. It wasn't nice. Alright, so how do we get over to that? These jars here. Get out of the way. Can we stand on the base of these? Maybe? Yeah, I totally can. Okay, great, so. Hopefully I can get up to one of these platforms from down here. Can I jump that high? No, I can't. we're supposed to get... Start from here. Let's turn this around. Don't look, the statue fell over. That's good to know. You can knock the statues down. Alright, we can definitely work with this. Get us higher up here. We can use this to get onto that platform. And whoa! Jeff's spike ball's falling around. It's very inconsiderate of you, spike ball god. Dropping them right in front of me. Alright, there's a switch right there. We just gotta deal with that guy. So I'll dig. But we'll ignore him, because we got the switch. Doesn't matter. Keep on going. Oh, is that... Hey, Amy, I don't... ruin everything. Okay, we'll do this anyway. We'll... Oh, jeez. Okay, that's good. Amy has a double jump. Her double jump is pretty crazy, actually, so... Get on over here. Was it Amy or crazy? Be invisible? That's... What? When could Amy be invisible? She could do that. That's really horrifying, actually. Can we hit? Okay, great. So Amy's got this hammer attack, which is actually the strongest attack in the game by damage. It's ridiculous. She could kill pretty much anything with that hammer in one hit. But the problem is actually getting close enough to hit it. She's also got an insanely high double jump. Look at that. It's like her second jump is twice the height of her normal jump. One up right here. Problem is you don't get a whole lot of horizontal movement, as demonstrated by that falling into a cliff, but we're no worse off for it, because we got that one up right before, so good stuff on that. And you know what? Now the invisibility, it's not useful enough. Just hit you. Blow you all up. Yeah, I'm not comfortable with the idea of Amy having invisibility. Like, it's bad enough she stalks Sonic and knowingly, but God knows what Sonic does in his free time, and Amy's just sitting there invisible watching. That's really unnerving. I don't like the idea of that. Amy shouldn't be allowed to become invisible. Hit you with... Okay, thanks. Thanks for being slow and having terrible reaction time, robot, because I could not hit you with that hammer any quicker. What does this guy do? But screw it, he's just gonna stand there. Who needs invisibility? This dude standing in front of an explosive thing. There we go. Hit the explosive box. Good job standing right in between. You guys too, you know? You're all smart robots. Thanks for just setting yourselves up for death. Go up here, this looks important. Is there anything over? Hey, it's a switch! Perfect, okay. Oh, the spike ball's still going flying. So that means this is open. Hello, how you doing? That's great. God, that hammer is so powerful, it's almost scary. Let's go left here. This looks like somewhere we can go. Good. Stop that. Drop all these, because great. You up here? Is that where we're supposed to? Yeah, here we go. Okay, so that'll open up this door. It's a long sequence with Amy, or maybe it's short and I just... Okay, good. Okay, we're back to Silver. No more of this Amy BS. Let's float across here. Oh, that's gonna... It's okay, we can stand on the platform it comes out of, which is really stupid, but it saved us from dying, that's good.
Those enemies look like they're guarding that door. Let's start by getting rid of them.
Oh crap, okay, so these guys are a little bit hard, because when they're all rolled up in the ball like that, you can't grab on, you can't destroy them or anything. But you can grab onto them when they're all electrocuted, they roll into a wall eventually, and then stun themselves. Which is good, because you'd eventually run out of things to hit them with here, like I think I just did. No, there's some boxes here. He's still alive, though. God, you take a whole lot of damage, guy. Great, I just broke all those vases. That worked. Are you kidding me? Just one more hit. Just gonna stand. No, stop. Oh my god. Okay, box, do your thing. Are you kidding me? Box, you're dead to me. You're worthless. Good, he stunned himself. Run away. Nope, giant robots. So they're gonna launch more of those robots at us. Even got them attached to their hands, so. And then. Oops. Whoops, whoops. Okay, that didn't work, but. So we'll get more. Roll them back at us. We'll hit them with. What? And they just bounced away. Okay, let's try this again. Grab those. Hit. Nope! Are they bouncing off each other or something? What is going on? Alright, grab them. Knock them down. Pick them up. Toss them a bit. Perfect. Is that door gonna. No, it's this door. Okay, let's see here. So, what does this do? Alright, raises us further. Great. Alright, so we'll use that to get the next one. And raise this one up. Oh, God! I'm just trying to grab on. Okay, fine. We can't do that here. Try to grab onto a missile, and you just end up trying to raise the platform even more instead. That's not helpful. That's counterproductive. What we need to... What the... No, you're right there. Okay, whatever. Let's get out of here. There we go. Alright, so if we just... Nah, screw that. Okay. There isn't a switch or anything. Okay, good, good, good. There's one of these here. That'll open up the door. And we'll be greeted by, like, 50 more robots. But... Hey, your spike ball's great. Just these exploding crates. These are always good. More spike ball. I love spike balls. Ow! I don't love getting shot. Getting shot mechanic seems so weird. You only lose one ring, and that doesn't seem like a huge deal unless you have one ring, and then just like everything's gonna threaten your life. But if you, is that done? Ow! Why am I still getting hit by stuff if it's done? Oh great, so another one of those glowing balls. Let's see what this is all about. Hey, silver medal. Alright, anyway, glowing ball. What do I have to do?
So I guess the lock will open if I put this ball in that hole over there.
Okay, so we'll line this up. Where's the hole? Is it that? No, it can't be that hole. That doesn't seem right. Keep rolling this forward. Maybe if I... Okay, so this hole... It's counting down slowly, so we gotta be careful with this. We gotta make sure it rolls into the right place. We gotta get it to the end of this hallway, and don't fall in, don't fall in! Good. Keep rolling, ball. You're doing a great job. Great job, ball. A little further. Hit you. Oh, there's not even a hole. I thought there was a hole. Oh, it's right there. Okay. So if I hit... No, no, don't you even think about doing... No! Damn it! I don't wanna go... Okay, you know what, boxes? You're coming with me. We're gonna try something here. The gold ring's right there. I can hear it. I just wanna get through this door. Maybe if I do this, I can jump through... Oh, I... No, did we? No. Can that work? Can we get through... Wanna do the ball thing again. I can't even get these over here. There we go. One more try. So can we get through? No, we were through the ceiling. That can totally work, but then the camera starts not working and okay, you know what? One more shot here. Oh, am I through? Nope! Whoops.
No!
That wasn't the right side at all. Fine, we'll do things legit. Don't try to do a trick or a glitch if you don't know how to do it. I very clearly don't know how to... Ball, you suck! Coming back? Can I get another one?
So I guess the lock will open if I put this ball in that hole over there.
I need the ball first. I need to... Oh! Alright, great. So if we line this up... Let's get this going. Let's get the ball rolling. It's off to a good start. It's a straightaway, so here's where you need to worry about. There's all sorts of holes in this ground. hit it off to the left. And then just go there. Okay, great. Put it over there. And then to the right. Those are gonna stop it. That's good. To the right, and then straight. No, damn it, that wasn't right. Okay, straight ahead from here. That should get it close, I hope. Oh man, I'm gonna run out of. There's no other way to wait for it. Wait for it. Don't you dare go. Okay, good. Good. Keep rolling. Don't you dare go down that. Oh my god, go in. Just go in, please. Bounce off that wall. Start rolling back. Can I hit it again? Okay, zero counts. It doesn't explode on one. Perfect. Let's get the hell out of here. Hate this level.
Great!
Billards from hell. I could play all the pool in the world and still be bad at that.
That was easy.
Not that I've played all the pool in the world, or even close to all the pool in the world. There's a lot of billiards tables out there, I would imagine. I've only really touched a handful of them, and a handful of billiards tables is about roughly one billiards table. Those things are big. Can't fit a lot of them in your hand. Most of those pocket ones. Those pocket ones are cute. They have those really tiny ones. Okay, anyway, story
Gee,
time.
I wonder where he went.
Maybe he's just very actively trying to be the... No, maybe he's right there. Never mind.
I've been looking for you. You're the ablest trigger.
What? He doesn't make cool floaty Your Jetson noises when I play as him.
Who are you?
I want to sound like a Jetson's car when I float.
My name is Silver. For the future of the world, I will destroy you!
Well, if it's for the future of the world, I guess that's only fair. So we all remember how this boss fight went, but that's when we were playing a Sonic.
Doesn't look like you're here to talk!
Definitely not. As Silver, this is gonna be a cakewalk, as you saw how that worked. It's very, very unbalanced, very unfair. And let's face it, I don't imagine Sonic Team programming this game well in any aspect. They're not going to make the AI for Sonic any good. He's just going to run into us and we could pick him up and we can't pick him up. That's not fair. He could pick us up. That's cool. There's still like a million things to throw at him. Let's just get all these tables and chairs. And... Ow! Okay, he'll home in on us, but that's okay. Not like an instant death or anything. This is going really well, actually. Take all this. Take all the furniture. Perfect. So I was told, yeah, a really easy fight that was very done fair. Silver's just a big bully. But that's okay this time, because we're on Silver's side and he's allowed to be a bully. Alright, so what happens when we beat Silver instead of the... or when we beat Sonic instead of the other way around? Probably nothing different, actually. I'm sure this just ends up the same. Yep, instead of having to throw him into a wall, he's already all cowering down. Totally matters, like I'm about to kill you, but I'm not gonna let you have the chance to hear both sides of the story first. So there goes Elise. Nobody cares, except for Sonic. But you're not allowed to care!
It's time I finally put an end to this! Amy? Get out of my way, Amy! This is my mission!
Absolutely not!
Damn it, Amy. Well, I'll just have to kill you too.
Thanks, Amy. I appreciate it.
Just, Silver, just throw Amy against a wall. Just get her out of the way. It's a little late now. Sonic's already gone, so... Maybe you could still do it for her, just screwing everything up. Just throw her against something. Way to mess up everything, Amy.
The person person you were looking for was Sonic. Were you planning to kill him?
Well, like, wasn't planning on giving him hugs and candy, if that's what you mean.
Sonic would never do that.
But it's true! In the near future, his actions will cause the devastation of my world, so
I
must...
kinda like my world, so...
I don't believe it. Even if that was true. If I had to choose between the world and Sonic, I would choose Sonic.
What? How does that... You are so irrational. I swear to God. So you have Sonic, but the whole world doesn't exist, so, I guess you don't have Sonic. Way to think that through, Amy. Way to be. Anyway, Silver's gonna reflect on how crazy Amy Rose was, because she's... You're not gonna understand it, buddy. You won't be able to get it. Well, here's Blaze, a rational character.
So this is where you are. I've been looking for you.
Oh, what's up, buddy?
What's wrong?
Girl troubles.
Well, Blaze? To kill someone to save the world. Is that really the right thing to do?
Well, if that guy's a dick, maybe.
You're so naive.
God, come on, Silver.
Whether it's right or wrong, I can't really say. But what I do know is... if we don't take this chance, the future will remain exactly as it is.
The future kind of blows, so think about that for a while. Not a great place to be.
Since he's after Dr. Eggman, let's sneak into Eggman's base. Maybe we'll learn something new.
How do you know that? When did we mention Eggman at all? When was he ever... What? Okay. Let's sneak into his base. We'll see what's going on. So, you remember his base. It's in the, I can't remember his base. Right, it's in the really weird name for all the White Acropolis. We have to go there. But first we're gonna buy some power-ups. Look, there's a ton of stuff for us to get. Grab all. And, the shock bracelet is definitely what we want. It's a very important thing to have. And I'll show you why that is later on, because it's one of Silver's more useful upgrades. We're gonna be able to do some pretty awesome things with it. First, we gotta find out how to get into White Acropolis. We gotta go over there somewhere. So, first of all, it's gonna do this. Jump up, hit the attack button, you come slamming down and hit anything around you, and that includes those switches there, which that's actually the only time you're ever going to use it for switches, so don't get too used to that one. It's just display to see how it is. But yeah, look at that, it displays it right there. You jump in the air, you slam down, it's going to stun everything around you, which is great, because once you pick up something that's stunned, well, like once something's stunned, you could pick it up and then you can throw it around and it's great. So we'll start off as Blaze again, that's also awesome. Blaze is a fun character to play as. And the good news is I don't have to go snowboarding or anything stupid through this level. A lot of robots to fight, but that's okay, because Blaze is good at robot fighting, except for right now. I just lost my ring, so... There's some. Alright, silver medal right there. You heard him. We gotta defeat them all. Not just the enemies we like, but all the enemies. And there's one up here somewhere. There he is. Let's defeat him. So that's what we're supposed to do. There he is. Okay, great. Lasers opened up. Continue on. You remember this part, except there aren't snowballs, they're just normal rocks. That's boring. Why are there normal rocks here? It's cool, they're helping take out everybody. Look at that. Great. Old avalanche again. I also remember this part, but now it's very straightforward. That, but whatever. We are in a hurry. We don't have time to collect medals. Just do whatever all willy-nilly. We also don't have to worry about that, because there's just a ramp set up for us. It's perfect. Don't have to try to jump anything super ridiculous. Every single enemy needs to be defeated. Alright, cool. So we finish that part up. Let's go to the next one. So I guess we get to play as Silver now. Maybe. We'll find out. I'm sure we do. We haven't played as Silver this whole level so far. There he is. Alright. Let's find out. Let's load on over here and see what's going on. Guess you don't feel like picking up missiles today, Silver. It's okay, you can grab them with your face, clearly. You're great at that. Alright, see if you get close to them now is another one of the power-ups. If you get close to them and hit the attack button, you might be able to stun something. But if you do the slam to the ground thing, then it just means you can do it quicker and more precise, because there's a whole bunch of enemies there. And if you jump right in the middle of them, you're just gonna stun everything, pick it all up, and throw it away, because fuck those guys. How do we unlock the cave? Probably have to take out that lamp, so break the searchlight. Or not, that's cool too. And the box comes back, so that's good. Maybe we can do it this time. Perfect. Can I do it? Doesn't matter, I'll just float there anyway. I'll stick around to see if it unlocked that. That's probably what we have to do with this whole thing, so. God, quit shooting me! I like rings, thank you. Take those stupid rocks. Take them to the face. Launch your rockets. There we go. Is that gonna do it? No? How about this? That do it? Perfect. Alright. Watch out for the spotlight can make more robots. That's okay. We're still up here. We don't have to deal with them. Just have to kill this one guy. He's already knocked down. So he blows up, the door will open. And into the next section.
Okay, a little further to go until the base.
So that should hopefully be the next section, or the last section here. Now we cannot deal with this level. We're almost over. So let's see, how does Silver get to the end? It's probably in the same place. So if we make our way over, let's take out this guy first. Blow him up, everyone's gonna blow up, fantastic. graceful move. That's just slam down, you stun everybody, and then boom, everybody's dead. There we go, now we can clean up. Sometimes it doesn't always work. Sometimes they could block it, like especially if it's a bigger monster, you could block it, but you just keep doing it, and it'll unstun everybody, or it'll stun everybody. Even the biggest monster is going to be just thrown about, like a big robot ragdoll. Okay, one of those down. Hit him in the face with his own hand. And there we go. I don't feel like waiting around for your own. Alright, cool, so there should be a spring or something in here. Ow. Okay. I'll take this guy out first. No more rockets. Okay. In here, can we break down into this? We're gonna have to hit it with something, aren't we? There we go. So I got hit. There's a spring. There's a one up. It's not a spring, though. It's not gonna be helpful. We gotta get up to that rail, and the rail brings us over to... Stop shooting me, I'm trying to think. Okay, so we can't grind that rail. Maybe we just follow it? Nothing else up here? Nothing at all? Under those rocks? No? Can we? No, okay, whatever. Can't blow up the tower here. No, it's just gonna bounce off. Great. Okay. Alright, let's follow this instead. Bring us to... Okay. Whatever. There we go, we'll jump across. I don't know why we gotta take any sort of rail anywhere. Or even if you do it with Sonic, but Sonic's just picky and wants to fly around everywhere like some crazy speed demon. It's not a rail, it's not worth it. So that seemed a little weird. Silver can't run very fast, but he's still on the side of that quarter pipe. So all these guys are in our way for it. Alright. Those boxes. Oh, god damn it! Really, spike ball? Try to throw you at someone, just hit a wall and bounce back and hit me. It's not nice. Thought you were my friend. It's a goal ring. Let's take it. Get on out of here. Perfect. Let's celebrate. Hopefully we got something good. What do we get? A rank. That's not quite an S rank. I'll take it anyway if that means that I don't have to be here anymore. And get our medal. Get our save phone. And get the hell out of here. However long that takes. That, wow. That was a very short
Looks
loading
like
screen,
we've
actually.
A little too late.
Uh-oh, what's that? Lots of rumbling. Lots of rumbling going
what?
On.
Oh, no!
What's oh, no? Why are you leaving us in suspense? I want to know what's going on. It's the Egg Genesis again. It's our buddy, a decent boss fight. Let's see what we have to do. Alright, we gotta defeat him, but obviously that can't be the same. I just can't home and attack up enemies and hit them, because that's not how Silver works. So I wonder how we fight him this time.
A guard, huh? Just try and stop me!
Don't you do it, because I'm gonna take all these missiles. Take a couple of these missiles. Throw them back. Alright, cool, so that doesn't seem too bad. It's gonna launch a ton of missiles. We can take all those missiles and we can throw them into people. So it looks like enough hits and anything. Take out one of those arms there. And just like the Sonic boss fight, take out all the arms and it should be good. So, Okay, quarter of the way there. Wait for these missiles. Alright, so got a few of those. See if we can... Oh. Alright, so hit them a little. It didn't do too much. The problem when he starts... When he does this, he drops some enemies to the ground, and then... Once that happens, yeah. See, when you throw things, they don't home in on the Egg Genesis anymore. They're gonna home in on those enemies that are on the ground. So you kinda gotta take some of them out, make sure they aren't in the way. Start throwing them again. There we go, see? You hit them right in that core in the middle, it's gonna do some decent damage.
Shake
them off. Okay, I'm gonna grab these missiles. Oh, those, I think that did enough to... Yeah, knock off another arm. Great. Three quarters of the way there. This is going very well. This is a fun boss fight even with Silver. This is just a well-designed enemy, I think. Grab all these. Throw them back. Okay, great. Doing some damage. Maybe a little bit more. Here we go, get some boxes, throw those up. They'll just bounce off, no biggie, whatever. A couple more. There's these missiles, that should do it. Come on. I didn't get any of those missiles. One more box somewhere. There's gotta be one out here. There we go. He's gonna hit. Let's hit. Alright. He's down for the count, but he's not out yet because he's got the he's gonna fall on us, and in order to do that, he's gotta fly all the way up in the air first, because it'll do more damage if you fall further, I guess. Silver's not as fast as Sonic is, but he still has no problem getting away. Alright, so we got that's not a good rank. Didn't do a great job there. Hate to say. But oh well, still beat him, we still got this out of it, and we'll continue on regardless. So what do we get out of this? Oh, it's a Chaos Emerald.
That's a Chaos Emerald.
It's good to know.
It said this gem can transform your thoughts into power. Collect 7, and a miracle's supposed to happen.
Well, that sounds exciting.
Keep it as a lucky charm.
Thoughts into power, huh? I'm gonna think about a cheeseburger right now, because I'm awful hungry after all this fighting.
It transforms your thoughts into power.
I don't remember the Chaos Emeralds ever doing something like that before. I mean, maybe I'm wrong.
I've been trying to find Sonic, but now I think I'm in trouble.
I hope you're in trouble, Amy. I hope you're in serious never finding Sonic again trouble. Maybe this will teach you to not do it
Maybe
anymore.
Maybe I should just walk away real quietly before they spot me.
Or maybe you should talk to yourself some more so people hear you and what the... Well, hello.
Prisoner has escaped from cell block C-17. All patrolling guards, begin searching immediately. I repeat, prisoner has escaped from cell block C-17.
Well, I guess they both get to escape, and now we get to... Now we get to have some fun with the two most annoying characters the series has ever probably come up with.
Thank you so much for rescuing me. I am so grateful.
I'm Amy. Amy Rose.
That's great, Amy Rose.
My name is Elise.
That's great, Elise. I don't want to be here right now.
Elise? Wait, you're not Elise, the Princess of Soliana, are you?
No, couldn't possibly be. That very frilly dress couldn't be a clue at all.
Someone I know said to me, nothing starts until you take action.
So I decided to heed his advice.
That's great, Elise. Why don't you take action with the guns and bullets in your face?
You have some feelings for this person, would you?
Please say no. Please say no.
It's okay. Love changes everything.
Know it, Amy.
It feels like every little moment in your life is huge.
Amy.
Doesn't it?
Don't encourage her, Amy. Don't do this to me.
What does this guy look like? Have you already been on a date with him?
No.
No, I really haven't.
Stop being embarrassed, Elise. This isn't natural.
Come on, there's no need to be shy.
There's plenty of need to be shy. It's an interspecies relationship. You never be open with those things. You never have those things. But if for some reason you do, you sure as hell aren't going to be open about it. Stop giggle. Stop it! Stop being... Just stop being. That would make me very happy, actually. If you just stopped. God, great. So it's bad enough that I hate both of these characters, but now I gotta save one of them by using the other. Fighting robots, that's gonna be exciting with Amy. Yeah, one bad guy is absolutely filled to the brim. There's so many bad guys going on here, Amy. I don't know what to do with them all. At least she does damage, you know? They could have been worse. It could have been that the hammer only did, like, one tiny little point of damage, and you had to smack everybody with your hammer, like, 40 times before anyone died. It could never happen, because, I mean, look at the range of this thing. Remember, at least in the other games, it turned bigger. It was easier to hit things, but now it's just got this tiny little hitbox. Practically have to run into every enemy here, which is what I'm doing anyway, so I might as well, alright? Screw you guys, I'm going after the middle one. You need to die. Stop blocking! Stop it! Okay, there we go. Very, very radical game. Very radical indeed. Really, put all these boxes here, we're gonna stun them all to the middle one. Blow them up with the... whoops. That doesn't matter. Okay. That right? And you can stop shooting things too. Okay, so we're done with that. Amy, you... No.
Aren't I just incredible?
No. Absolutely not. We'll use your own quote against you. Hope it hurts. Hope it cuts you deep. I hope that's the last time I have to even see Amy. If she's never in another Sonic game again, I'm really gonna be okay with this. Can we just celebrate 20 years of Sonic without her? That would be the best. Uh-oh. Oh gosh, they're everywhere. God forbid you actually get to a castle, Elise.
Finally, I've been waiting so patiently for you to return, Princess.
Oh, Robotnik, you're so sweet and generous. Glad you're patient. Oh, and finally back to characters and matter in this series, and this guy.
Mephiles.
So, what's up, Mephiles?
Who is the Iblis Trigger? Why does he want to destroy the world?
Why does that matter to you?
It kind of matters to me. I would
Unless
like to know.
Unless you complete your task, your future will remain the same. Forever. He's currently at the terminal station. It's now or never if you want this.
Just want a question answered, but... Yeah, if you're gonna be that way... Guess we'll go to the terminal station. After these loading screens. You know, I thought about cutting all these out at some point. I really did, but I don't feel like you would have gotten the full gaming experience out of it. And I need to present these to you in full, complete, all of its loading screen form. Every last bit of its loading glory.
Hey.
So you're gonna... Look at him swinging his arms. He's crazy. I guess we're gonna go buy a power-up before anything happens here. Just get that power-up.
Hey.
Alright, shut up. Let's see, where is that thing? Where'd it go? Right here somewhere, isn't it? Right, and then, yeah, we just go over here. It's like right in front of this clock tower here. Perfect. Okay, shock bright there. Oh, hard to win. That's different. Okay, we got the shock bracelet already. That was that awesome thing I was telling you about. So, look, we can do that now, and it's pretty worthless, actually. I mean, fly forward like a foot. All the time we spend jumping, we could just, you know, walk. Ooh. So that didn't seem worth it, but I mean, you know, we gotta advance the plot that way, and then let's advance the plot that way. Let's see what's going on here. Okay, so we get to get into the station now. It's a stealth mission. There's gonna be all sorts of guards and everything around, and you gotta make sure not to wake up any of them, or not wake them up, but make sure that they spot you, so. If they spot you, they're gonna ruin everything, cancel out the mission. You gotta hide between all these barrels here, use your special new ability to... Now, you know, we're just gonna charge on ahead. I'm just kidding about all that. Doesn't matter. Look, we're done already. I didn't use that stupid...
Perfect.
Look at that, S rank. That was such a colossal waste of time. I didn't have to use that new power-up once. I didn't have to do anything there, really. Except kind of walk forward and... Whatever, man. Alright, so that's over with. Let's jump into the level now. You couldn't have just jumped into the level at the end of that, you know? That would have made too much sense. I would have sped things up a little. Anyway.
I'm not going to let the Iblis trigger get away!
Okay, cool. So it's train time. You know, clearly this can't be as fast as it is in Sonic's story, but we still can't let the train get away. So we gotta do whatever we can to... These scales here, we gotta get the boxes off them, because once that happens, the scales start moving again. So here we go.
This conveyor belt changes direction. I'd better be careful.
Oh, this actually makes silver go faster. That's nice. Pretty wonderful. Bounce up on... There we go. Almost missed it. That would have been terrible. So this part right here, you gotta... So we can't get up there normally, so we gotta drop these boxes on there. Weigh this down a little bit. And see, now we can get up there. Not too bad. So be careful of these conveyors. Get this, it'll help you out. Get to that other side. You hit by rockets, that won't help you out, but I told you to do it, so you should. You should, actually. I don't want you to throw those rockets over there, Silver. There's like a bunch of robots in front of you. Let's just throw them all into the cliffs. No biggie. Doesn't matter. That's taking forever. Can I just kill you? Please. Thank you. Great. Look at all those. It's shooting a ton of them. Jeez. Alright, so... That was worth it for the 1-up, I think. The 1-up's still very important. Doing an alright job with Silver Story, but it could change at any second here. stock up while you can. I don't trust this. Anyway, that one. Down there. Alright, so then all these kind of hub places, you take out all the enemies here, and the door should open up, kind of like Sonic Story. Come out. Oh, just kidding, it's not even a door, it's... Alright, so the big guy's in our way now, so we gotta kill him. Well, that's just a crappy wooden barricade. I'm sure we throw something at it. Probably. God, they're all just bouncing off of each other. There's too much stuff here. Can't break it if I can't even get to it. Get that ring box. I want rings. Come on. Maybe explosive one. Oh, damn it! I wanted that. Will you break, you stupid wall? I just... I don't want to be in this room anymore. I'm glad this isn't time, because I'd be stuck... And now it's stuck behind a pillar. Great, I'll grab this one. Throw this right there. Perfect. Couldn't have done that to begin with. Saved everyone a headache. Whatever. See, that's cool right there. That is exactly what that power-up is good for. And I'm going to use that at every opportunity, because if I don't have to throw things at people, then I don't have to throw things at people. See, look at that. Just a whole bunch of arrows, and they're all gone. It's very simple. I don't have to worry about anything anymore. They got with that desert one we got. Just do that from the very beginning. These conveyors are super quick. Stand on here and charge up our meter hole. That one up. Let's get that. Can we just stand in the middle? A little? Okay. Alright.
I can't grab lasers with my psychokinesis. It looks like I can only avoid them.
I don't know why lasers are a new thing to Silver. Like, they've been there forever, we've been fighting those guys for a while now, so you just now decide to combat on lasers? I don't get you, Silver. Don't get you at all. Can we just get over there? I don't want him shooting us before we float over, but it'll be okay. It'll be fine, alright. Just all worried over nothing here, look at me. Robots that Silver has to fight. He's a fighting hedgehog, definitely. Sonic didn't have to worry about this many people, but he just ran past anyone anyway. I don't know, Silver's just... He's fun, I guess. It's a completely different type of character, and it gets a little boring after a while. I'll be the first to admit that, definitely, but... It's definitely something different for a Sonic game, and it's kind of new and refreshing, really. Over here.
I can't attack enemies I can't see.
Still stun enemies you can't see. Look at that. You can see them now. Perfect. So now we can get on over here. Get that. I don't know why we had to do that, actually. Could have just hit that spring to begin with and moved on. It's okay, though. We'll fight these guys. And hopefully it should be the end of the level here, because I don't see Silver doing a mock speed section anytime soon. Get out of the way, debris! You're... Oh my... What the hell was... That was... Alright, anyway, end of the level. Cool, we're all done with that. What did we get? Let's celebrate. That's... A-ish. Ow. Maybe it's not. Never mind. I lied to you. Okay. Still got this, that's nice. Save that data. Sonic again. He saved the princess, and we know how this goes.
you again.
Oh, it's Silver. He wants to pick
this time,
a fight.
There will be no more interruptions.
Kill each other quickly.
The endless trigger must die.
I saw this cutscene in Sonic's story, but I'm keeping it for completion value. Like I said, I'm not gonna skip anything. You might not have seen Sonic's video, in which case, welcome. I appreciate you watching things. In whatever order you choose, actually. So, you know, give you that choice. You don't have to watch Sonic's story. Maybe you've seen it before and you don't feel like playing Sonic again. And I don't blame you. So Shadow's clearly pissed off. Now we get to fight him. One Sonic gives him the thumbs up and runs away. We gotta wait a while to fight him, of course. Nothing just happens instantly in this game. Certainly not when one of these pops up. That's okay, we can...
Here I come!
Is it bad when I'm surprised that a loading screen doesn't take that long? Like, even if you gotta sit through another one like this, that loading screen wasn't too bad. It's getting better in degrees here and there. And we'll appreciate what we get and when we can get it. But for now, we gotta defeat Shadow, and this is gonna be a tougher battle in Sonic. But Shadow actually puts up a fight here. He knows how to fight. He hit us with his Chaos Spear. It stuns you, and while you're stunned, you get hit while you're down, which is pretty terrible, but we'll work with it. Got all these barrels here. You can pick up a barrel, throw it at the Shadow, and wait around for him to home in on us. Do it again. We'll run away for a little while, pick up some more barrels. We do this back. Oh, I got a mind pick. That'll hurt, right? I hope so. Yeah, Shadow kind of means business here. It's a lot harder to fight than Sonic is. He's got a lot more attacks. And we'll just keep... See, you could pick him up too, which is a weird thing. You pick up Shadow, but once you throw him, nothing happens, and he just falls to the ground. So that's cool, we can do it, I guess, but it doesn't do an awful lot of good. We'll just keep hitting him with barrels. I'm sure there's plenty of them around here. They keep reappearing after I throw them. Definitely no shortage of barrels. You can count on that. Takes a whole lot longer to beat, so you can really dig a hit. Get stunned again, home in on us, and it gets enough time to get ringed and get out of here, so. That's good, too. He's got this red glow around him. I wonder what that is. Like, I seriously wonder what that is. I guess maybe when he hit him enough times, he goes into that. Maybe his attacks are stronger or quicker or something. I don't know exactly, but you do know to stay away from him and keep throwing things. So that's exactly what we're going to do. It's working pretty well so far. And he just needs a... There we go, another hit. That's done and over with. No more barrel throwing for us. Sure, that took forever, so that'd be great. Oh, that's pretty close to a mess, actually. It's surprising. Alright, A rank for us. Get our crazy emblem thing. Here we go. Alright, so let's see what happens here. We just kind of left him as Sonic to do whatever, so.
Chaos control!
Don't. Silver's gonna be a dick, or Shadow's gonna be a dick. Oh, they're both dicks, whatever. A whole bunch of jerks kicking each other in the head. And of course, Silver's arrogant and stubborn.
With the Chaos Emerald's power,
Shadow is also arrogant, but. More of an asshole about it.
I won't give up. It all depends on me. Can't lose.
Other statements that aren't full sentences. Oh, he's got a Chaos Emerald too. What's he gonna...
Chaos control!
What? When did you know I... You're just blurting out words now, Silver?
You induced chaos control.
Well, it worked for you, so I thought I'd give it a shot.
I'll change the past and save the world.
That's great, Silver. Good job on that. I believe in you.
Mephiles isn't trying to help you create a better future. He's trying to eliminate the past.
What? What are you talking about?
To discover what happened. It seems we must see what took place 10 years ago.
Let's go in this convenient time portal. It takes us 10 years ago. Just it happens to be what we made, you know. Well, okay, you know. That whole time travel thing was so stupid, but we'll see where it takes us in the next video. See you there.